Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel, JT Open Stuff. Today, guys, we are going to be doing something I've wanted to do for quite a while. We're going to take a look at one of these Walmart Adventure Force Baja Brutes. Now, I saw these pallet stacked getting ready for the Christmas season, and these are super inexpensive remote controls. Are they just for introductory level remote control enthusiasts, or does this thing have the performance to even make somebody like me enjoy their remote control session? We're gonna find out in today's video. I'm gonna open it up right now. We're gonna review it, and I'll let you guys know what I think at the very end. Now, like I said, this was about $39.99. You could see you can race up to six drivers at once. Really neat tempos on the side there. 1/8 radio controlled vehicle. As you can see, lithium ion rechargeable, full function, precise control RC vehicle. Now, I'm gonna try to get a little bit further back here. We can take a look here at the side and at the back. Range of 100 feet, runtime of 40 minutes, ready to run. Again, rechargeable battery, fully function, working suspension, moves forward, backwards, left and right. And it has working taillights, as you can see right there, and working headlights. So we're gonna spin this around, we're gonna get right into this, and then I'm gonna charge it up if it needs to be charged. But if it's ready to run, we're gonna take it out and we're gonna test it out because, guys, I love remote control cars. I think in today's age of getting kids outside more, remote control cars are the best way to do that. They are super fun. This one even looks like it might be the size that you could put a little figure in there if you want to, a little G.I. Joe figure or something like that, one of those little Adventure Force fighters. And I just think it's a cool looking car. So for 40 bucks, I thought that there was no way I was going to let this go by without taking a look at it. I really don't think you need to spend $250, $300 or more on a remote control car to have fun. I have spent that much on remote controls in the past because I do love them a lot. But if this is as cool as I think it's gonna be, this would be a great entry level car for anybody out there that's looking to get into the RC world. And honestly, guys, nowadays, as expensive as things are, anytime you can save a little bit of money and still get something that's a high quality, that is a bonus. So we're gonna find out what the quality is of this car so that you guys can know whether to go out and pick it up for your kids for Christmas, or maybe just a friend, boyfriend, well, I don't know, whoever, girlfriend, grandpa, I don't know, whoever you wanna get it for, guys. But we've got that end cut open there. Let's see. You know what? Let's just rip that box off. I know I'm not getting a lot of it in view right now, but the opening table is not the hugest table in the world. Okay, we've got our instruction book here. And now let's see. Looks like just some glue or something right there. There are some batteries right up here and a little USB. It says you charge this via USB, so that's gonna be kind of interesting. Let's clip out a little remote control, kind of a standard looking remote control. We'll take another look at that in a second. And let's see. You know what, guys? I'm gonna rip this right out of here, right off camera. All right, that's a little bit better, but as you can see, that's kind of what comes inside. The remote control was right back there. USB cable is right there. Let's see if we can. Right into there. Oh, you know what? Oh, there you go. It's looks like it's already in the car, perhaps. Weird. All right. So we'll put that right down there. See if we can get these batteries out now. I'm assuming these are for the controller. I'm guessing that the USB charging is for the car itself. And that is going to be something new for me. The other remote controls I have are a few years old and they're all battery packs. So having something that's just a USB charge, I don't know. We'll find out how convenient that really is. Well, let's see here. Here we go. Batteries are out. And then we've got these little screw things. I actually think these are much better than all the ties and stuff that they put onto things, onto toys lately, but just a quick turn and they pop right out. So that is loose. We'll put those right over there in the trash. Guys, hear something in the background. That is Olive. Olive is the cat that lives with us, and she is going crazy because there are squirrels and birds galore outside. It has been beautiful weather here in South Carolina, and she is going nuts watching the squirrels and the birds that are outside. So that is probably what you're hearing. Now, as you see here, this USB cable is already in. It had a little piece of tape there. I didn't really notice that until I started pulling it out there. But no batteries or battery packs in there. But I'm guessing... I'm guessing maybe you could just kind of wind this up in here when you're not wanting to charge it. Let's see if it will fit like that. It's a very unique way of doing things, but looks like it might fit. All right. Let's see. That went into there. Let me try this with it just like this first. So that went in the back side there, and then that popped in like so. Okay, and then to open, just kind of pulled that off, I guess. Interesting. All right, let's do this. Let's give it a real quick glance at the instruction manual here. Switch vehicle on off, brush areas where dirt gets trapped, wipe body clean with a soft rock or soft rag, not a rock, a rag or cloth. Do not use chemicals to clean. All right. Proper use support. Well, guys, that is all of the instructions you get here. Just making sure that I'm not missing a page. Is there another page? Feels like there could be, but yeah, there we go. I'm just having a little bit of a hard time getting that piece of paper apart. So here we go. All right. So you can switch it on off. You can align the wheels if your car is not going straight. That's really good. Has working lights. And that is exactly what it suggests doing. Rolling that up and putting that in there. And then putting batteries in the controller. All right, so let's start And look at that, guys, a QR code to activate your warranty. Interesting. This controller is not as super high end as, you know, some really expensive remote controls, but what a fun little looking remote control. It's got the trigger button, steering, everything you need. All right, now let's see. There is not in this one. Let's get these batteries out. I noticed something that we were missing, looks like, but easy fix. Put this battery in there. Now, if you notice, there is a screw hole right here that there was not a screw in. So I don't think that's going to be a problem because that snapped in there really, really well. Really well. Again, just a plastic controller, but kind of nice weight to it. All right, let's turn this on. Let's see if it has any charge at all. Oh, look at that, guys. It does. So we're going to turn that off. We're going to try to wrap this thing up as best we can. Get this in there. We're going to figure out how to get that little latch on there snugly. And we're going to take this bad boy outside, and I'm going to give you guys my honest opinion about it. I don't know how much of a charge it'll have, but maybe it'll have enough of a charge that we can find, get a little top speed test going, kind of see what we think of it in general. Now, I don't know if I can get that in there any tighter than that. So then this, went in there just like so. All right, popped right in there this time. Guys, we are, I think, ready to roll. Turn that switch on right there. This is where you can adjust the alignment of your front end. Nice little plastic body on this. A little bit of loose wiring sticking out here, so could get caught up on some things, I suppose, but not the end of the world. Can see right in there. If you wanted to, I'm sure you could take the time and really tuck those back in there really nicely, get them out of the way. All right. Let's see the suspension. Not a ton of give, but can see there is some. And on the front end as well. All in all, guys, the car itself is a really nicely made little car. Obviously, lots of plain black plastic, just decoration on the areas that need decoration. But all in all, for $40, I mean, this is pretty sweet. All right, let's turn that on. Give you guys a little show right there. Very little delay, if any at all. Give you guys a look at the wheels. Now, I will say, I just noticed, I thought maybe it was because it wasn't powered on. This wheel only has about this much turn. So it is not a really turn it hard to control your car. So we're going to see how that affects the operation, but that is the first thing that I've really noticed that I think could be a lot better, give you a lot more feel if it was a little bit more of a actual steering, kind of a wheel there. But hey, guys, we're going to take this outside. We're going to test it out. Thank you so much for watching so far. Let's get this thing out there and see what it can do. All right, guys, so here we are. We're outside with the Baja Brute. Again, just a reminder, $39.99 at Walmart. Perfect, looks like, anyway, a perfect little kind of entry-level remote control for somebody that might have never had one before. We're gonna give it a test and we're gonna find out. Now, with most of my more expensive remote controls, you just toss it and go. So let's see what happens here. We're gonna give it a speed test down the driveway and back. Then I'm gonna give it a little bit of an off-road test. And then we're gonna go out onto the road and we're gonna see how long it will actually run. It says it's got 100-foot range. We're gonna check that out. So here we go, guys. Terrible. All right, let's try it again. As you can see, the lights are on right there. And it's an amount of speed. It's not going to be the fastest thing ever. And for the charge right over the box, this is pretty cool. So let's get it on up here. We're going to give it a little off-road here. That is actually pretty good performance, guys. This little car is definitely fun. The steering does take a little bit of getting used to since there's not a lot of play in the wheel. Let's go see how far we can make this thing go. Now we're going to test the 100-foot range of this Baja Brute, and go. Probably 50 feet away right now, still some control. Probably 100 right now, and just lost control of it. So, nice little distance away, guys. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching today. I would definitely recommend this Baja Brute for any beginning RC enthusiast or somebody that just wants something cheap to bang around outside. Thank you guys really much for watching. I'll see you on the next video.